Friday, third attempt at the start of group 1 round 15. It's the last 7 flights that seniors need to do. Organizers had some technical difficulties with the timing system, and then the shower passed us, and now it looks like it's back in order. He's now just testing the air and exploring what he can do. But I guess that was too low. To do anything at this time of day. Few other planes there above the corridor. And they appear to be doing just fine. There's a slight breeze now in my back. Wind forecast for today is something like 4 meters per second, gusting up to 8. So with occasional shower rolling in maybe during the day. So one just passed us. And I assume the difficulty will be something in between the quiet days and the windy days that we had. Still, this last round is an opportunity for people to gain some scores, last opportunity for them, so I'm sure they will be fighting for it. And the other ones that are happy with their scores, they will fly to keep the same ranking. So some people also fly to protect their team ranking, which means, or I expect to see two kinds of starts here, some low risky starts and some high safe starts. This guy was hoping for more than he got. But But such is life. So everyone else I see is now really high and will have no problems making the time. I guess good news for this guy. He needs some more height to finish the full round. Okay, clock worked fine this time. So we'll continue with the next group. Round 15, group 7, final act of the qualifying rounds of this first world championship, provided that there are no mid-air collisions and reflies, of course. It's a few minutes past noon, and let me show you the clouds. Puffy cumulus clouds are now popping up everywhere around us, accompanied with a decent wind, about 4 meters per second as forecasted, which makes for a perfect flying environment. I don't see anyone going low in this group, which means they are all happy with the results and are just trying to protect what they have. They are not risking too much. This group is the lowest. And if they make it, then others are in no danger. Late, some technical issues with the altimeter, I would say, or nervous finger on the throttle on the radio. And even he's not starting low, he's going to the middle of the flock. Issues besides the clock, organizer's clock this morning, I've seen at least 3 cases where planes were flying with spinning propeller, and this is against the rules and should be disqualified. But for one case, I know at least the guy who was flying with propeller spinning didn't get a zero. One case landed in the corn, over 75 meters. The third case happened this morning. I still have to check the results once they're published. So all 3 cases happened because the motor controller didn't apply the brake, either because it wasn't configured properly or there wasn't enough juice left in the battery for it to do that. But still, I think these kind of issues should not be happening on this class of competition. This guy is now moving downwind and climbing happily. And since we have less wind than Wednesday, for example, I'm sure he'll be able to make it back too. Yeah, so he's now safe. What's the rest of the group doing? I have to find them where they are first. They're still kind of holding together over the parking area and the buildings. It looks like they will also make this flight without difficulties. The lowest plane at the moment is over here. He looks a bit desperate, looking for some good air. He wasn't able to find any. Minutes to go, and I'm not sure this will be enough. I can hear these guys' servos now. Ready to land? Okay, now let's wait for the results to see the final team ranking and who made the flyoffs.